Welcome to Epic Space Models. In this video, I will give you a guided tour of the BFR booster. Let's get started. In a previous series, we made the upper stage of the BFR, aka the spaceship, as proposed by Elon Musk in September 2018. This time, we turn our attention to the first stage of the BFR, aka the booster. What you are looking at now is a finished 3D printed model of the booster. This is a 100 scale robotic model with a total length of 68 cm and a diameter of 9 cm. Let's have a look at the distinctive features of this booster. At the back, we have a cluster of 31 C-level optimized Raptor engines. In this model, the engines are lit using 3 colors LEDs, which provide a great flexibility to create realistic ignition sequences. On the side of the engine block, we find 3 fixed fins. Moving up, we find the propellant tanks. And finally, at the very top of the booster, we find the interstage and the grid fins. The grid fins are used to control the attitude of the booster during the atmospheric re-entry until the booster lands. They are folded during the launch and unfold just after the booster separates from the upper stage. In this model, each fin is controlled by 2 servo motors. One controls the rotation of the fin around its hub axis, and the other one controls the folding and unfolding motion. Since there are 4 fins, this means that there is a total of 8 servo motors crammed into the interstage. Now, let's crack this model open and see what's inside. This is what we get after separating the different segments. First, let's have a look at the engine block. So, at the bottom of the rocket, we find all the LEDs of the 31 Raptor engines. So, each engine has one 3-color LED that can be controlled independently. So, here is the central engine, and then you find 3 rings of LEDs. So all these LEDs are connected in series. So here you find the wire bundle coming from the control board, and it is connected to the central engine. So the red line is the plus 5 volts, the black line is the neutral line, and the yellow line is the data. So the data line is connected to the input pad of the central engine, and then the output pad is connected to the input pad of one of the LEDs of the inner ring. And from here, it goes one full cycle clockwise. And then from this LED here, it jumps to this one on the middle ring. And from here, one full cycle again, until it comes to this one. And from here, it jumps to this LED on the outer ring and goes one final cycle. So using only one data line, you can control all the 31 LEDs independently. Next, in this segment, we find the control board. So this control board is exactly the same design as for the spaceship. And this means that we have 2 Arduinos connected via an ITC bus. So the Arduino on the right side of the screen controls the 8 servo motors, and the Arduino on the left side of the screen controls the LEDs. So the reason why I'm using 2 Arduinos is that the library controlling the servo motors and the library controlling the LEDs don't work well if they're placed in the same Arduino, because they're both using timer interrupts. So if you are interested in knowing more about this topic, I talk about it in detail when I did the guided tour of the spaceship. So I'll put a link about this video in the description below. So one of the things that you will notice is that the biggest part of this model, which is this white like circular section where we find the propellant tank, well, it's actually the most empty. Because if we look inside, we find, well, nothing, almost nothing, but the wire running up to the interstage. So now let's go to the most interesting part, which is actually the interstage. So this is the interstage, and this is the part where you will find the 8 servo motors controlling the grid fins. So just to give you an idea of the size of this part, so the diameter is 9 cm, so it is a bit less than the half of the width of my hand, and the length is maybe 6 cm, it's not that big. So first, at the bottom of this part, we find 4 servo motors, if I can get the camera to focus. So you have one here, you have another one here, another one here, and the last one here. So if I put my finger on the servo motor, this gives you an idea of the size of this hardware. So these 4 servo motors are used to rotate the fin, so to change the pitch of the fin, and that is what is used to control the attitude of the booster during the atmospheric reentry. So if you look closely, you'll see that on the top of the servo motor, you have a servo arm with 2 metal pins sticking out. And to this pin is clipped the push-pull linkage that is connected to the fin hub. So this is how the motion of the servo motor is transmitted to the fin. So if I can get the servo motor to move, this should be easier to understand. So first I will deploy the fins. And now I will have this servo motor move. So I'll try not to shake the camera too much. Here we go. And now you see that the servo motor is moving. And when the servo motor is moving, it pushes one of the link, pulls the other one, and this rotates the fin. Okay, now I can show the same thing from the other side. So now we are seeing the interstage from the top. So these circular parts here are the hub of the fins, and they are used to both transmit the rotational motion of the servo that we've just seen just below the interstage, and there are also mechanical support for the other servo motor, which is used to fold and unfold the fin. So first, let's finish with this push-pull mechanism. So if I move the fin again, you will see this hub rotating back and forth. So you see that you have 2 pins sticking out from the side of the hub, and to these pins are connected 2 links, and these links are connected to the servo motor below. And as I explained in a previous video, with this kind of mechanism, you need to prevent the hub from moving sideways. And this is the role of this pillar at the center of the interstage. So if I had not this structure in the middle, this part here would be free to move in the horizontal plane and it would not work properly. So if I can show the rotation of the fin from this side. Come on. And now you see that the fin can rotate about 45 degrees left and right. Now, what about the folding and unfolding motion of the fin? So to fold and unfold the fins, we use the other set of servo motors. So these servo motors are located here, 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 and here. So you can see that they are like bolted directly to the hub, so that when the hub rotates, basically the servo motors swing up and down. So when you create this kind of mechanism, you want to be very careful because you don't want this motor to bump into anything when it moves inside of the interstage. So how does it work? Well, you see that what you are seeing here actually is the main body of the servo motor, but the head of the servo motor is actually going just inside of this hub. If I try to show it, okay. Now you see that on this side of the hub, you have a hole here. So this is a service hole so that I can put a screwdriver inside and tighten this screw at the inside of the hub. So this screw is the top of the servo motor here, and it is used to secure an arm on the shaft of the servo motor. So hidden inside of the hub is a link that connects the servo motor with the grid fin. So now you cannot see it because the fin is unfolded, but if I fold the fin, I'll put it in the setter for the moment. If I fold the fin, and try to get the camera to focus again, you see that here we have like a hinge attached to the grid fin, and just between these two gray tabs, you have one black part. And this part is the tip of a link that goes right through the hub and connects to the servo motor. And now if I have the servo motor move, if I manage to click my computer while holding the camera, okay. Now, what's happening is that the servo motor is basically putting the link inside of the hub, and this pulls the grid fin, and this makes the grid fin rotate. I just have the fin rotate around the pitch axis one more time. Okay. So what was complicated with creating this mechanism? Well, the first difficult point is that each fin has two different motions. So an engineer would say 2 degrees of freedom. And because of that, you need two motors, so in this case, several motors, and you need to have one fixed to the interstage and the other one moving. And in this case, we have one of the servo motor, which is swinging with the hub. And the other really difficult point is that, well, we don't have much space because we have the 8 servo motors in this tiny space. So we have to be very careful about how the parts are moving to avoid any part bumping into one another.
This concludes this series about the BFR booster. So, what's next? Well, don't worry, I have other epic models coming live soon. So, stay tuned! And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.